At this time, I would like to call Buchtel's color guard up to the stage. At this time, I'd like to call Marcus Jaywan Black to the stage.
Hello, my name is Marcus Jaywan Black. Please stand as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated.
Order, on.
At this time, I egg on a swan.
Hi, my name is Ariana Swain, and next, at this time, I'll call Demaya Barker to do the invocation.
Welcome. My name is Demaya Barker. The 2022 senior class of John R. Buchtel CLC. And I would like to welcome you as we celebrate 13 years of hard work and dedication to Akron Public Schools. Please bow your head for a word of prayer. Dear Lord, we come to you giving thanks for allowing us to make it this far. We realize that without you, we can't do nothing. We give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. At this time, I invite senior Nadia Renee Yoruboro Carroll to the podium for the alma mater.
Oh, Buchtel, high to you we bring
Good evening and welcome to the Class of 2022 Commencement Ceremony. Welcome to our parents, guardians, grandparents, aunts, uncles, brothers, sisters, cousins, friends, and other guests. I want to welcome our honored guest, Superintendent Christine Fowler Mack, Executive Director of Project Grad, Jackie Silas Butler, Vice President of the Akron Board of Education, Dr. Derek Hall, Board Member Bruce Alexander, and tonight's keynote speaker, Marcus Jennings, as well as other esteemed guests. I am honored to be addressing my first graduating class as campus principal of my alma mater. And your soon-to-be alma mater, Buchtel CLC. I am very proud of the accomplishments that you have been able to achieve thus far, and I'm excited for the positive impact that you will have on the community and the world around you. I have watched you all grow from little boys and girls to beautiful young men and women. I want to thank the parents and guardians for trusting your child to the loving and educated staff at Buchtel CLC. One thing that I've heard people say over and over again when it comes to Buchtel is there is a love and a care that you receive when you are a member of the 1040 family like no other school in Akron. We are a true family who has our fair share of ups and downs. Sometimes we may disagree, but ultimately we win. And by we win, I mean we support each other in the classroom, on the court, on the field. We're getting a new turf, y'all. On the track, we have several state contenders this year. They're gonna bring another state title back on Saturday. On our jobs and our pathways, we win. And with a support system this great, it is hard to lose. Please know that the support system does not end tonight. You are a griffin for life. That means whatever you need, someone in this village has your back. My hope for you as you navigate through life is that you are able to achieve everything that you want to achieve, understanding that whatever you want to achieve is going to take hard work and dedication. I hope that the struggles that you have endured have made you a better, more resilient person. My hope is that the love, support, and resilience that you experienced at Buchtel sustains you when times are tough. Even the times when you did not experience love and grace taught you life lessons. You learned that sometimes things don't turn out how you thought they would. You learned how to respectfully disagree with someone. Well, some of you did. But this is going to be something that you will need to be successful in life. As young adults, it's time to take accountability and admit when you're wrong. There is nothing wrong with apologizing sometimes. As young adults, it is time to express your emotions in a more mature manner. Love hard, forgive often, focus on your goals and your dreams. Remember that what is supposed to happen for you will happen when it's your time and according to your purpose. Figure out what your purpose is. So I want my graduating seniors to do me a favor. I want you to close your eyes just for 5 seconds. And I want you to think about where you want to be in 5 years. And I'm gonna steal this from my mentor, Mrs. Fowler Mack. I want you to reach up with one hand and grab that goal. Okay, keep your hand up. Reach as high as you can, okay? When you don't think that you can reach any higher, reach a little bit higher for your goal. It is important that you know your goal so that you are not, you guys can put your hands down, thank you. It is important to know your goals so that you are not wandering aimlessly through life and whatever happens to you just happens. Pick a goal and stick to it. Do not allow others to take your eyes off of your goal. Know that there are going to be obstacles, but you are a griffin, the master of the land and the air, and you can do anything you put your mind to. You survived the pandemic. You can do anything. Turn in your seats and look at someone in this audience that has helped you along this journey. Thank them because you did not get here alone. It's taken hours of classes, echo, study tables, scheduling, counseling sessions, lectures, prayer. Even when you don't know someone's praying for you, they're praying for you. And family support to get you where you are now. Some students didn't get it together without some tough love and some consequences, but everything worked out to get you to this day because you set your eyes, your mind, your talent, and your energy on this goal. Even with all the love and support, you ultimately did the work. And that's why we celebrate you today. So last but not least, in the famous words of Snoop Dogg, I want you to repeat after me. This is for the senior class only. I want to thank me. I want to thank me for believing in me. I want to thank me for doing all this hard work. I want to thank me for having no days off. I want to thank me for never quitting. I want to thank me for always being a giver. And trying to always give more than I receive. I want to thank me for trying to do more right than wrong. I want to thank me for just being me at all times. And if you want to hear the rest, you're going to have to YouTube it. I am very, very proud of all of you. I love all of you. Not gonna do it. And I'm not. The staff loves you, and on behalf of Buchtel CLC, I wanna wish you all the best in the future, and congratulations. And now I'm going to invite Ms. Damaya Barker, our senior class president, to give her address.
Well, this is it, guys. Our senior year has come to an end. We all have reached one of the major milestones in our young lives, high school graduation. When I look back on our time together, there are a few moments that stand out to me. Do you remember the first day of our freshman year when we were touring the school alone, exploring our new stomping grounds, and realizing we were fresh meat at the bottom of a totem pole? As the years progressed, we experienced the feeling of getting older. We understood and knew we were gonna have some good times, but we didn't realize we were making memories. We just knew we were having fun. We can't forget about the pep rallies, the dances, and all the various field trips. These moments were all learning experiences, as well as becoming our own individuals while simultaneously growing together as a class. The one moment we can't forget about is March 13, 2020, the last day of normalcy before our lives changed forever. We would be out of school and away from each other for a full year. While virtual learning was honestly a learning experience, we all got through it. I would like to thank all of my classmates for the loving support you guys have given me for over the 4 years. I would like to thank you for illustrating me, for being your class president. And I'd like to thank my family and friends, as well as many supporters. OG, Shamika, Miss Mia, Nuge, Miss Karbowski, and Miss Beecher. Most of all, I would like to thank my mom for always being my biggest supporter and helping me through the hard days. Our graduation serves as a launching point, projecting us to wherever our futures are meant to take us. Whether we land ourselves in a career, take up a trade, join the military, or continue our education at a college or technical school. We all wanted school to be over until the day comes, and all of us will be sitting in alphabetical order in a cap and gown. With the people who have watched us grow up and the people we have watched grow up. Then we realized that some of these people will be in our lives for forever, and some of them we will never see again. Throughout 4 years of high school, you'll think somewhere along the lines they would have taught us how to say goodbye. And everybody will want to know what we would do if we didn't graduate. I guess we'll never know. That's all, folks. I stay up here. Do I introduce the guest? And now I would like to bring up Ariana Swain on the stage.
Marcus Jennings, Buchtel High School graduate, was named the Deputy Director of Athletics and Chief Operating Officer August 3rd, 2021 at the University of Akron. His primary focal point is football, sport oversight, and external operations of the department. In his role, Jennings provides strategic leadership and is responsible for broad supervision of the athletic department's external units, which include fundraising, communication, ticket sales, marketing, branding, multimedia rights, licensing, and merchandising. He also has sports oversight of baseball, cross country, and track and field. He is a key member of the leadership team and is counted on to make many of the day-to-day decisions for the entire athletics department. Jennings returned to his hometown after 8 years in his role as Associate Athletics Director for External Affairs at Sacramento State, where he provided leadership, strategic planning, and oversight for the Hornets 21 sport athletic program. Jennings oversaw Sacramento State's external operations, which included fundraising, marketing, branding, promotion, media relations, ticket sales, and a corporate sponsorship program. Additionally, Jennings served as a chief diversity officer while leading the department's diversity and inclusion initiatives. A former Division I baseball player at New Mexico State University, Jennings worked in the private sector for 14 years before returning to the athletics as a special assistant to the athletic director at NMSU in 2007. The following year, he became the development director for athletics at Valparaiso University and spent 3 years at Kent State University as an assistant athletics director. Jennings is currently the president of the executive committee for the National Association of Athletic Development Directors. NAADD is an organization which provides educational and networking opportunities for intercollegiate athletic fundraisers across the United States and Canada. The purpose of the organization is to establish overall prestige and understanding in the profession of athletics advancement and fundraising. Jennings earned his bachelor's degree in business administration from New Mexico State and added an MBA with a concentration in finance from Clark Atlanta University. He and his wife, Brenda, have two children, Masad and Baziana. Let's welcome to the stage, Marcus Jennings.
All right, I'm a little shorter here, so let me put this down a little bit. You know, what's interesting is I can put myself in that seat 34 years ago. Wow, 34 years ago, sitting and saying, what can I do to be a better person? And I don't want to take too long, but I have a couple comments for you guys, and I hope it's something you can get out of it. So number one, I want to say congratulations to all the 2022 graduates. This is a monumental day. No matter where you go in life from here on out, no one will be ever able to take away your education. You're all destined for greatness. Listen to me again, graduates. You're all destined for greatness. Let me begin by telling you a little story about the most influential person I had in my life as a student at Buchtel High School in the late 80s. Yes, I'm old, of course, but her name is Isla Shriver. She was my business administration teacher. I had Ms. Shriver for my junior year and senior year. And at the time, I really didn't know how much of an impact she would be for me. If I ever needed any extra help academically, or even needed advice on which college to attend, Ms. Shriver was my go-to person. I am sure she was really just doing her job at the time, but this was very impactful for me because I really knew that she cared about me. As I reflect back on how fortunate I was to have a teacher like Ms. Shriver, the reason I want to share this story is really because of teachers who have a positive impact on our lives. So after all the education I've been through, Ms. Shriver at Buchtel High School was the person who was most influential for me. So I'm a product of a great education from a great institution and a teaching staff that never gave up on me. So right now I do want to publicly thank her for being the teacher she was for me and continue to be a great friend that she is today. I had invited her out for this ceremony, but she couldn't make it. So now I gotta first of all thank Google because I lost touch with Ms. Shriver for about 10 years, but I was able to find her. I wanna thank publicly my wife, Brenda, and my children, Masood and Basiana, along with my parents, Gloria and Jean Jennings. I have my mom with me here today, and she remembered back in 88, we were out on the campus at Akron at this graduation. So there's really three things I want to get across to you guys today. I hope this is a good takeaway for you. Number one, dream big. Number two, have confidence in yourself. And number three, be a leader. Okay, so whatever you aspire to be, dream big. There's nothing you cannot accomplish, and don't let anyone tell you differently. Not your mama, your daddy, your grandmama, friends or foes. You must master what you want to do. You are the master of your fate and the captain of your soul. Whatever you aspire to be in this world, go for it. Don't let anyone tell you what you can or cannot do or dictate your value. Life is about choices, so don't forget that. You will be accountable for those choices as well. So every day, make sure you make the right choice. Life will be tough. You all know that, but that's okay. As a Buchtel graduate, you're built for this. Remember, tough times don't last forever. Tough people do. As I've gotten older and hopefully wiser, I've realized no matter what, when things get tough, I must continue to tell myself, this too shall pass. As you proceed on your journey, remember to have faith. Obedience to task involves hard work, faith, and hope. It involves perseverance. That quality in people that keeps one going when everything else seems to have given out, except you must carry on. I just want you to give you this last piece of a poem. All my brothers of Omega Psi Phi, they know this poem in their sleep. But I've learned this 30 years ago. And the poem is See It Through by Edgar A. Guest. So I'm just gonna read you the last stanza of it. I don't even have to read it. But even hope may seem but futile when with troubles you're beset. But just remember you're facing what other men have met. So remember that. Anything you're going through, remember you're facing just what other men have met. You may fail, but fall still fighting. Don't give up. Whatever you do, eyes front, head high to the finish. See it through. Next is confidence. Confidence is the trait that will carry you in everything you do. It's in the simplest form, confidence just means believing in yourself and knowing that you can do it, whatever that task is. In many cases, we are our worst enemy. We're our own worst enemy. Having confidence in yourself is going to separate you actually from everyone else. In many cases, that thing we call confidence is something that you got to work for daily. Because again, we talked about life is going to be tough. I'm not telling you that it's going to be easy to have confidence at all times, but if you work hard at it, condition yourself as a confident person, you will see the results in every aspect. And finally, be a leader. And this is an interesting piece because you all will lead in different ways. You don't need to be the rah-rah guy to be, come on, let's hurry up, let's go. You can lead in your own way. I'll give you an example of my oldest son. He's a 16-year-old. He's a pretty soft-spoken, low-key guy. But you know what? His leadership is displayed in relationships. There are times, I'll use an example. Obviously, he's a baseball guy as well. But there's times when there's someone's feeling down. He'll go up to them and say, hey, don't worry about it. I got your back, right? That's his form of leadership, the relationships he's built with people. So as I end, really, I just want to say, be safe, treat people well, that nothing is different than the golden rule. Treat people how you want to be treated, and don't ever give up on yourself. If nothing else, if you leave this today, remember, don't ever give up on yourself. Because if you give up on yourself, there's no reason why someone else should believe in you. One last piece before I go, but thank you guys. Where there is love, there is life. Where there is life, there is hope. Where there is hope, there is faith. Where there is faith, miracles can happen. Where there is peace, there's God. And when you have God, you have everything. Thank you.
And at this time, I want to welcome Demaya Barker back to the stage.
I would like to introduce Cynthia Rivera Pilater, the Salutatorian.
Good evening. I'm Cynthia Rivera Peralta, the class salutatorian. It is my pleasure to welcome our parents, teachers, family, friends, faculty, and staff. Most importantly, I would like to give my warmest welcome to the amazing Buchtel class of 2022. Before I start my speech, I would like to thank my family for their guidance and support. I am blessed enough to have a family that is wholeheartedly proud of my accomplishments. I would also like to thank Mrs. Hinkle, a science teacher that never actually had me as a student. Nevertheless, her classroom was always open for me. The best friendships, the best moments, and the greatest ideas I had in the last 4 years began in her classroom. Ms. Cinco has been the emotional support I needed throughout my high school career and has truly earned the title of a school mom. Lastly, I would like to thank my parents for their sacrifices. My parents immigrated to this country 20 years ago. They came with nothing but still managed to give me everything. Their blood, sweat, and tears will not go in vain as I begin my journey into being a successful young woman. I am proud to say that today, I will become the first woman in my family to graduate from high school. Not only that, but their hard work and dedication were able to create a salutatorian, a title I am proud to have. From here, I can only say I can only go up, or we can only go up. I've been told that my job here is to salute you all for your accomplishments. With that being said, I salute you all for graduating high school in a global pandemic and experiencing the pain that was online classes. I salute you all for your impressive accomplishments. It's so inspiring to see my kids my age starting businesses, making music, making art, becoming TikTok famous, becoming great parents, and more. Lastly, I salute you all for being Buchtel. When I moved to Akron 4 years ago, I honestly didn't like it. I didn't like the Griffin, or school colors, or Buchtel school spirit. But I have learned to love Buchtel and the people that make Buchtel, Buchtel. I've grown and I've realized I love it here more than I did New York. And although New York will always have a place in my heart, that's where it will stay. As for my peers here in Buchtel, this is the sweetest, funniest, and most supportive class I have ever been a part of. And I'm so happy to be able to say that I was a part of it. It hurts me to know that Buchtel has been painted with negativity and stereotypes of hostility that don't fit the Buchtel that I know. The Buchtel I know is humble, supportive, willful, and much more. The Buchtel I know honors their people, whether they're dead, unborn, or living. The Buchtel I know will one day leave the world. I'm not saying that this class is perfect, because of course we have our ups and downs, but I will gladly say with all my heart that the students in front of me right now will one day become amazing leaders of the world. Doctors, nurses, lawyers, architects, scientists, lash techs, nail techs, hairdressers, the list goes on. We are quite literally the roses that grew from concrete. And though our individual stories might be different, what we all have in common is that we come from humble beginnings. One day when you're satisfied with how far you've come in life, remember your origins and that you were able to create something amazing from so little. My favorite saying in Spanish is, te vas a comer el mundo, which translates to, you're going to eat the world. It means you'll overcome any obstacle that comes your way, even if it's as big as the world. So to my peers who have made it this far, never doubt yourself. Remember that you were able to graduate high school in the middle of a global pandemic. If you can do that, you can do anything. With that being said, may you all eat the world. I love you all. I would like to introduce Kayla Robinson, the valedictorian.
Hello. Hello, family, friends, and other esteemed guests, and my fellow scholars in the class of 2022. My name is Kayla Marie Robinson, and I am your class valedictorian. I would like to start off my speech by saying it has been a long 4 years, and though we weren't physically there for all of them, it didn't make it any less tiring. And I don't know about any of you, but this day has been marked in my calendar since my freshman year. Ever since that first day of school, when I walked through those main high school doors and went straight into the wrong classroom, I had a vision, not a dream. I'm no Martin Luther King. I was standing on this stage doing this speech to all of you, but enough about me and all my glory. I want to talk about each and every one of you and how far you all have come from babies to beautiful young adults. Malcolm X once said, education is our passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to the people who prepare for it today. This day is simply just a stepping stone towards something greater. a future that only you hold the key to unlock. Not your amazing mom or dad you love so much, or grandma and grandpa that just want the best for you. You, because I'm not gonna say we're grown now, but we are grown up. We've been through it all. Personal tragedies and hardships, being called into Preston's office. Not me, though. In his book, I'm still young lady, which I'm not complaining about. At this time, I would like to thank those all around me who helped get me to this point. Mrs. Hinkle, without you, I would have drowned in my own mind. So thank you for keeping me and my, I'm gonna be valedictorian, self afloat. And to my family, without you supporting me, even from afar, I wouldn't have had the same drive to succeed as I do now. And to anyone else who has personally touched my heart, whether recently or years ago, I sincerely thank you and will carry the memories of you along with me for the rest of my life. Because this is it, the starting point to the rest of our lives. Now, I ask you all to take a moment and think back to a time where you may not have believed you would make it this far, and close that door. That isn't your reality anymore. You made it. We made it. You're sitting in that seat, waiting to walk across this stage and receive your diploma, the one you worked hard for and earned, that no one can take away from you, that no one else but you can do anything with. Whether it's straight into the workforce, army, or college, from now on, your choices are only made by you, and they only affect you. So use those brilliant minds of yours and choose wisely, because Ms. Edwards will be watching. As I wrap up my speech, I would like to read a short poem that I wrote at 1 a.m. this morning in slight turmoil, because it wouldn't be a speech written by me if I didn't include a poem. I have bloomed, blossomed into a flower of great proportions. Though I've been stepped on, plucked, and dehydrated beyond belief, I still grow. And I plan to keep on growing. For when winter comes, I know I'll wilt away, though with a vengeance in spring, I'll be here to stay. As I know that the journey to full blossom makes it all the while to experience the seasons and to gain true peace and to keep on growing, for I have bloomed. Thank you, everyone, and congratulations to my fellow seniors. Have a great Griffin Day. At this moment, I would like to call up Layla Shepherd.
Hello. First, I would like to thank Ms. Booth, because she helped me with literally almost everything. I couldn't find the right words to write this speech, and I threw words out there, and Ms. Booth actually wrote it down for me, and we came up with my speech. While today is a day of celebration and joy, it is also a day for us to honor a fellow class of 2022 graduate and classmate. Raymond Raza was my friend as well as a friend to many others. Ray sat across from me in our business class. We spent a lot of time talking about world problems, personal problems, and we also helped with each other's assignments. One word that comes to mind when I think of Ray is understanding. Ray was always a good listener and always kept it real with me when at times I needed someone to talk to. Ray always took the time to be fully present and receptive to what I had to say. Ray always had a smile on his face, no matter if he was having a bad day. He always seemed to radiate positivity. As I move forward with life and begin my future, I will strive to incorporate these qualities into who I become, and I challenge you to do the same. Ray was a true friend and never gave up on anyone. We need more people like Ray. Thank you. Next up, Ms. Buchtel.
On behalf of Buchtel CLC, I would like to present Raymond Wanzo's high school diploma to his mother, Ms. Robin Wanzo.
Hi, guys. On behalf of Raymond Wanzo, I know he would have been like, yeah, that's great, guys. Let's keep going. So that's what I want you guys to do. Keep going.
At this time, I'm going to invite our senior class vice president, Leah Cheatham.
Okay. I would like to talk and say that Attorney Jacqueline A. Silas Butler has served as the Executive Director of Project GRAD Akron since July 31st, 2006. Project GRAD Akron is an educational reform program which has established in 2002 to increase the high school and college graduation rates of students in selected schools of the Akron Public Schools. Project GRAD Akron provides services and programs for students from kindergarten through college. The program areas include academic support, social services, college access, college awareness and readiness, mentoring, and scholarship. In 2006, the organization has awarded over $2 million in scholarships to graduating seniors. Under her leadership, Project GRAD Akron's team members implemented the Bridge to Kindergarten program for incoming kindergarten students and their parents. Enhanced programs to increase high school and college graduation rates of students, implemented the Achieving Dreams Celebration fundraising event, the March Gradness fundraising event for scholarships and college access programs, the Turning Tassels Leadership Society, and provided an array of educational programs to increase student and parent engagement and involvement, including College and Career Central and the Grad Mentors Program. Recently, she is the co-author of a multi-year million-dollar grant to benefit students in the Akron Public Schools. A native of Middletown, Ohio, she received her Bachelor's of Art degree in History and Political Science from The Ohio State University and her Juris Doctorate degree in the University of Akron School of Law. A licensed attorney in the state of Ohio since 1984, her legal career includes serving as a magistrate with both the Summit County Juvenile Court and Summit County Domestic Relations Court, an assistant prosecuting attorney with the Summit County Prosecutor's Office, an adjunct professor at the University of Akron School of Law, where she taught juvenile law and an adjunct professor at the university's undergraduate school, where she taught legal research and writing attorney. Silas Butler has always interested in utilizing her legal backgrounds and experiences to the community and has served on numerous board commissions and committees. She has been the president of many organizations and the recipient of numerous awards and recognitions. She is an active member of the Arlington Church of God, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Inc., the Akron Bar Association, Akron Canton Barristers Association, chairman of the Summit County Human Resource Commission, just to name a few. She is married to Lawrence B. Butler, Jr., and a retired music teacher with the Akron Public Schools and have one adult son. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good evening. It is my pleasure to make some brief remarks on behalf of Project Grad Akron. As was stated, Project Grad Akron is part of a national organization aimed at increasing high school and college graduation rates for students. And we have been selected initially by Dr. Sylvester Small, who used to be the superintendent of the Akron Public Schools, to bring the program first to Buchtel. We started in 2002 in Buchtel, and a few years ago, we went to North. We're currently at East, and we're very proud of a program that's going to take about 1,500 students that we're following from the sixth and seventh grades all the way for the next 7 years until they graduate from high school or their first year of college. We look at our students in the Akron Public Schools as family. And the one thing I can say about Buchtel, and just listening to all your speakers today, even the alumni, family is so important. And then to see the young man's mother who came to receive his graduation diploma helps us all realize that life is so very precious. You young people are very precious to us. You mean a lot to us. You mean a lot to your families. And we don't want you to ever lose sight of the fact how important you are to our community and to our world, but most importantly, to yourselves. As you sit here and think about graduation and where you're going in life, I hope you really listen to the words of your principal. She asks you to raise your hands high and reach, and continue to reach and reach even harder and higher. It's so important for young people to understand that you do make a difference in our world and in our community. And you may not see it now, but you really can make a difference, and you are making a difference. Your voices need to be heard, you need to be engaged, and you need to be active. If you looked at my notes, I don't have any of these words on my program, but I'm really led to encourage you to be active citizens. Most of you are 18 or will soon be 18 years of age, and you have the ability to make a difference by voting. I hope you are all registered, and if you are able to vote, that you will do so. A little bit more about Project Grad. As we stated, we're going into our 20th year next year, and all of our scholarships, for 99% of our scholarships, have gone to students from Buchtel. We are so proud of our students. We have awarded nearly $2 million in scholarships to students from Buchtel. It's a lot of money, and it takes a lot to raise this money. And so we're just very proud of our team that works with our students in Buchtel as well as in the Akron Public Schools. The grad that you see on some of the students, it's a kente cloth stole that we had made, and they were sent to us here from Africa. The GRAD stands for Graduation Really Achieves Dreams. And as you heard from our keynote speaker, you can dream so much and you can do so much with your lives, but you have to believe in yourselves and you have to believe that you can do it. We believe it, we see it, even if you may not see it sometimes. We see it, your family members see it. So tonight, I would like to congratulate all of the graduates. It takes a lot to graduate from high school. A lot of people will tell you that, oh, it's no big deal, you just have to go to school, but I commend you. Can you imagining that you had to learn virtually for over a year? When the pandemic hit, we're still experiencing the pandemic, and we're suffering from it in so many different ways. So I congratulate each of you because you do have it. You have it within you, and I hope you believe it as well. So, in closing, we have a few additional scholarships we would like to award tonight. These students are not aware that they're receiving these scholarships. So Sharnay Chapman will receive a $1,000 scholarship. Caden Marks will receive a $1,000 scholarship. Zariah Jackson will receive a $500 scholarship. Demaya Parker will receive a $350 scholarship. And Aneris Gould will receive a $350 scholarship. Two additional scholarships are named in memory of two people, or three people at this point. The first would be the How to Be Indy Scholarship, the India Douglas Scholarship. Many of you may not, you may know her sister, Ashlyn Allen, or her brother, Dante Douglas. They were both graduates of Buchtel, as well as India. India graduated in 2013 from Buchtel, and she was a loving, caring, dedicated young lady and a friend to many. On her way to class in 2015, after she had graduated from high school, she had just left her home that morning, and she died as a result of injuries she sustained in an automobile accident. You just never know how life is so precious, and just simple tasks and duties, you just don't know. So we're very proud to award a scholarship in the amount of $500 to Manaya Rober. Finally, Atha and Muriel Walker had five children who all graduated from Buchtel High School. Their family loved Buchtel, and they always wanted to make certain that they did things to support students. The family has provided scholarships to students through Project Grad, and tonight we will award a $1,400 scholarship to Thomas Cherry. In closing, to all of the students, congratulations. Keep your eyes on the prize. Remember, graduation really achieves dreams. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to introduce our Vice President of our Akron School Board, Dr. Derek Hall.
Greetings and salutations. First to campus principal, Ms. Beecher, and to all of the faculty and staff of Buchtel High School, thank you for everything you do on behalf of the children and families we serve at Akron Public Schools. Your continued and ongoing dedication to our mission, especially in these difficult times, is obvious and appreciated. Please know that your collective efforts have never for a moment gone unnoticed. It is these collective efforts that have powered our students and allowed them to reach momentous milestones like this. My name is Derek Hall, and I'm the Vice President of the Akron Public Schools Board of Education. And on behalf of our board, including Board President Dr. Akbar, Bruce Alexander, Joe Perry, Carla Jackson, Valerie McKittrick, and Dinah Autry, I want to welcome all of the students, parents, families, and friends to our ceremony. And to the graduating class of 2022, congratulations on your outstanding achievement. As an APS graduate, class of 1994, it is an honor to be asked to address this year's graduating class. I hope you know how much it means to be able to share this moment with you and to offer you what I hope you will take as a spirited challenge as you take both your first steps into the rest of your lives. Taking those first steps is both Buchtel High School alumni and graduates of the Akron Public Schools. Now, I have spent a significant amount of time over the last several weeks trying to come up with something profound to say or to share with you. That pressure has also been increased in light of these tumultuous times. Now, I don't want to be overly philosophical simply for the sake of wanting to sound smart. Rather, I would prefer to challenge you to consider three practical pieces of advice. And it is here that I turn my attention to those of you sitting in the front, the students, the graduates. I'm not talking to anybody else in this room, I'm talking to you all, okay? Number one, practical advice. Don't know what you don't know, know what you know. It is rare that any of us get through a day knowing the answer to every question thrown our way. Our credibility in life depends on the ability to simply say, I don't know. It is difficult to succeed in any environment, home, work, school, when people believe that you will make up facts or give them wrong information rather than say, I don't know. Perhaps the hardest moment to say or acknowledge that you don't know something is when someone expects you to know the answer. And let me give you a practical example. I was in the grocery store the other day, and there was a student, he may be from Buchtel High School, may not be, and he looks at me in the line, he says, Dr. Hall, man, I like your drip. Now, in the moment, I had two options. I could act like I knew what he was talking about, or I could simply say, you know, I'm not sure what that means. Now, what do y'all think I did, graduates? What do you think I did? I did kind of act like I knew. I did kind of do that. And I'm looking at what I had on, and I thought, you know what, like, I mean, I'm G'd up. What's he talking about? Drip, right? So I had this nice suit on too. And I'm like, there's nothing dripping on my suit. I didn't spill anything in my suit. What's drip? What you talking about? So I had to check myself, my ego. And after I tried to play it off like, oh yeah, you know, my drip is strong. I then had to say, okay, so what's drip, what's that mean exactly, drip, you know? So he explained to me it means swag, among other things, right? So I appreciated that. And then a couple of nights later, I was talking to another student. And this student was talking about their mama's lasagna. And they said, you know, my mama's lasagna is bussin'. Now, again, I had a choice to make. What choice am I going to make? Am I going to act like I know what he's talking about when he says bussin'? Or am I going to say, you know what? I don't know what bussin' means. But I would sure like to know, because this sounds cool. So in that moment, I made the wrong decision, because I tried to act like, this is bussin'. You right, this is bussin'. And then I had to say, and the student was looking at me like, nah, you don't know what I'm talking about, you know. So I just said, you know, you're right. I don't know, but can you educate me? What's that mean? Bussin'. That means that lasagna tastes really good. That is some really good tasting quality cuisine style lasagna. Okay. My point being, if you don't hear yourself, I don't know, at least once a day, then I suggest you check yourself. It's okay to say, I don't know, especially when it's followed up by, I can go look up the answer and get back with you. Remember, credibility is important because it functions as the foundation of trust. Number two, y'all with me still? You looking? All right, okay. Never stop, never stopping. Now, I borrowed this from a film, but the point is important. Graduating from high school is a significant achievement. Celebrate this moment. Embrace it. Never forget this moment in time. But do not let this be the peak in your life. You all have a wide range of talents. Do something with those talents. Whether you pursue a trade, start your own business, choose to serve your country in the military, or attend college, never stop, never stopping. In time, you will come to know people. Hear me, are you with me, right? In time, you will come to know people who will swear that high school was like the peak of their existence. Don't be that person. Be the person who continue to better themselves afterward. If you figure that the average life expectancy is somewhere in the mid-70s, peaking by age 17, 18, or 19 still leaves a lot of life to live. So never stop, never stopping. Strive for excellence all of your day. And finally, that third piece of advice. We might need some audience participation here in the back in just a second. Understand that failure is oftentimes a necessary step towards success. And now, when I say success, I'm not talking about money. I'm not talking about pocket watching somebody else's money. I'm talking about having the opportunity to pursue something that you are passionate about. In my own life, I have failed as much as I have succeeded. And it wasn't the failure that threatened to finish me off. It was the inability to evolve or learn from failure so that I could be smarter, better, wiser as I move forward. Now, I could give you countless examples of athletes, inventors, actors and actresses, singers, gamers, soldiers, carpenters, engineers, teachers, guidance counselors, and principals, all successful people that have failed countless times on their way to achieving success in life. Michael Jordan. People in the back. Is Michael Jordan the greatest basketball player of all time? No, I ain't talking about y'all right here. I'm talking about the wise folks in the back. Is Michael Jordan the greatest basketball player of all time? Or is it LeBron James? Okay, graduates, same question to you. Is it Michael Jordan or is it LeBron James? Okay, all right, we got a lot of LeBron love up here. Okay. My point being though that whoever you got, Michael Jordan or LeBron James, think about this. Michael Jordan took 7 years to win his first title. 7 years. Okay? Alexander Graham Bell. We got these lights up in here. Do you really think that Alexander Graham Bell? I'm sorry. Do you really think those of you who have cell phones, right? Do you really think that the cell phone or the telephone got invented on the first try? No, it didn't. And all these lights we got up in here. Do you think Thomas Edison really invented the first widely used light bulb on his first try? No, he didn't. So history is full of examples of successful people who first had to fail and fail a lot in their ultimate journey towards success. So don't be afraid to fail. It's a natural part of life. Just make sure to learn and evolve after each mistake so that you are always the better person moving forward. Class of 2022, know that we are proud of you and everything that you have achieved. Know that as you proceed through life, you will always be a part of the Akron Public Schools family, no longer as students, but as proud alumni. Thank you again to all of the parents, grandparents, family members, and supporters that have joined us for this ceremony in honor of your graduates. Thank you for trusting us with your children and for being their biggest champions. We know how proud you must be of your graduates. In closing, class of 2022, you have all come so far. Y'all thought I was done, didn't you? Yeah, I got one more paragraph. Why y'all rushing me off the stage? I got one more paragraph left. Okay. In closing, class of 2022, you have all come so far and achieved so much. But remember, this is not the end. It is merely the end of the beginning. While these are challenging times, I have the utmost confidence that you will find your way. Remember to say, "I don't know," at least once a day. Set short-term, medium-term, and long-term goals for yourselves. And remember that failure is often a necessary step towards achieving success. So have the courage to stay the course, and remember that it is through hardships that we reach the stars. Thank you, congratulations, and go Griffins. Now you can clap.
All right.
Thank you, Dr. Hall. At this time, I would like to recognize several groups of students. First of all, I would like to recognize those who are in the top 10. Please stand when your name is read and remain standing until all names have been read. Please, parents, try to hold your applause until all 10 names have been read. Kayla Marie Robinson. Cynthia Rivera Peralta. Demaya Nicole Barker. Sharnay Latrice Chapman. Dannon Nathaniel Williams. Savannah Tynice Hendon. Anaris Natasha Yvette Gould. Kuaden Mikkel Marks. Leah Mackenzie Cheatham. Tylasia Zaire Cardina Coffey. Now you may applaud for your top 10. Be seated. Our class of 2022 National Honor Society members, please again stand when your name is called. Demaya Barker, Sharnay Chapman, Leah Cheatham, Acacia Coleman, Alana Lehman, Kuaden Marks, Kayla Robinson, Amira Leah Vincent, and Tayana Whitaker. And Tylasia Coffey. Please give it up for our 2022 National Honor Society members. We also want to recognize our class officers. Our president, Demaya Barker. Our vice president, Leah Cheatham. Secretary, Ariana Swain. And our treasurer, Kayla Robinson. Please give it up for our 2022 class officers. The next five young ladies that I'm gonna call also earned an honors diploma. Damaya Barker. Sharnay Chapman. Leah Cheatham. Cynthia Rivera Peralta. And Kayla Robinson. Thank you, ladies. A few moments ago, you heard from our Executive Director of Project Grad, Mrs. Jackie Silas Butler. As of yesterday, our scholarship amount was $1,089,899 has been awarded to the class of 2022. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. The presentation of diplomas is symbolic of the completion of students' high school studies. We realize this is a special day for you and your graduate. For some parents and grandparents, their graduate might be the first to do so. Therefore, keeping with the dignity of the graduation ceremony, I respectfully ask that you hold all applause and refrain. I gotta say it. And refrain from other distracting demonstrations, such as noisemakers, balloons, and this one you have to do, sorry. You have to stay out of the aisles until the name of your graduate has been read, so that each parent and guest will be able to hear the name of their graduate. Please help us make the evening with the class of 22 a shining example for all classes to follow. There will be appropriate times throughout the evening when we will be asked and encouraged to recognize those graduates. On behalf of our superintendent, Mrs. Fowler-Mack, our vice president, Dr. David Hall, I am pleased to present you with all the rights and privileges earned the John R. Buchtel CLC Class of 2022. Mrs. Edwards, could you come up to the podium, please? And we will begin the presentation of diplomas.
All right, class of 2022, give it up! Kayla Marie Robinson. Cynthia Sari Rivera Peralta. Damaya Nicole Barker. Sharnay Latrice Chapman. Dannon Nathaniel Williams. Savannah Tynese Hendon. Anaris Natasha Yvette Gould. Kiaden Michael Marks. Leah Mackenzie Cheatham. Tylasia Zaire Cardinay Coffey. Ariana Faith Swain. For the Huntington Academy of Global Industry and Design, Michael Douglas Beecher Jr. Labierre Dwayne Belton. Marcus Jaywan Nathaniel Black. Dion Anthony LaShawn Brown. Hunter Lee Grand Campbell. Osiris Travell Kamarion Cody. Acacia Monet Coleman. Jasmine Ann Curry. Amira Daisha Gloria L. Antonio Lamarius Evans. Dawn Carmelia Ferguson. Raven Simone Ford. Nellie Arielle Gissendanner. Natea Tranice Goodwin. Mayana Jean Grace. Kayana Gina Nicole Gwynn. Terrell Tyrese DePriest Harris Malone. Jermel Joseph Holloman II. Zaria Christina Jackson. Todd Dwayne James Jr. Amina Elin Johnson. Soraya Sharde Kendall. Tamarion Lamont Naff. Sincere Martha Artrice Littlejohn. Shania Elise Logan. Frederica Mignon McLeod. Anaya Trachelle McCormick. Janelle Emmanuel McCray. Tony Lee Motley. Tamia Kyrese Owens. Danita Marika Palmer. Tyson Jerome Perter. Damaris Michelle Reynolds. Jeremy Duran Richardson. Keyshawn Andre Roberts. Marquez Lanier Rogers. Eric Javon Scruggs. Layla Monique Shepherd. Treyance Deshaun Short Jr. Dejan Malik Shoulders. Andre Philip Sinkfield III. Nyron Montrese Spragley. Teron Rayshon Stevens Jr. Elise Marie Nicole Thomas. Emmanuel Isaiah Thomas. Jamil Latif Townsend. Tyrell D'Angelo Joe Tucker. Nevaeh Amanda Twitty. Kayla Nicole Washington. Deanna Renee White. Dejan Dwayne Wilson. DeMichael Cartier Wingo. Tyreek George Marcel Wood. Nadia Rianne Angelique Yarborough Carroll. Ty Lauren Hope Yarborough Carroll. Lanijah Nevaeh Star Hamilton. Javion Jagreek Littlepage. And now for the Summa Health Academy of Leadership and Innovation. Thomas James Anderson III. Imani Deborah Belfield. Deshard LaRue Belton. Cassidy Ann Blackman. Anaya Cherie Carey. Michaela Ashley Carter. Shantanae Janaya Carter. Christian Alexandra Chandler. Janae Chantel Chapman. Thomas Henry Cherry Jr. Cameron Lamar Davidson. Tiana Lamarie Dotson. Diavion Elisha Edwards. Jalen Dion Finley. Jamar Nasir Finney. Javina Christine Fry. Tamaya Renee Gates. Deontay Webb Glover. Alonzo Alexander Jamal Goldsboro. Sharice Capri Hall. Kaya Alyssa Samara Hughes. Tian Torrey DeLords Hunter. Elijah Kanye Jefferson. Xavier Lee McClendon. Damara Joanne Nellum. Lanaya Nicole Newcomb. Jordan Alexander Parson. Davielle Talia Party. Jordan Tatiana Lanice Pearson. Richare Antoinique Portis. Terrell Anthony Robinson. Manaya Janae Roper. Dominique Kaliqua Smith. Tiana Denise Steele. Santasia Renee Taylor. Jalen Lee Thompson. Kanaya Montea Janai Lene Trice. Amelia LaJoyce Vincent. Kevon L. Leon Welker. Tayana LaTanya Whitaker. Antonay Alizé Wigglesworth. Brandon DeAndre Williams. Lamar Deshaun Williams Jr. Sky Mackenzie Mystique Williams. Karan Rashad Windham. LaQuest Tion Beasley II. Miguel Antonio Reyes Jr.
Give it up one more time for our class of 2022 graduates. To our parents, guardians, grandparents, families, school staff, and friends, we would like to say thank you. And please bow your heads for a final word of prayer. Again, Lord, we come to you saying thank you. We want to thank you for everything that you have done in our lives. Now, as we leave this place, but never leave your presence, we ask that you protect us and keep us in your loving arms. All these things we ask in your precious name. Amen. Mr. Lingenhole and Ms. Booth, our senior class advisors, please come on up. Before we do the last ceremony, I want to say thank you to the unseen staff who supported us tonight. Dr. Hughley, Mrs. Brownhall, Mr. Turner, Mrs. Kerfman, Ms. Mia, Ms. Hunt, Mrs. Ramsey, Mrs. James, Mr. Lingenhole and Tess Booth, Mrs. Sewell, my bestie, Mrs. Brewer, our safety team members, our SROs, our parent volunteers. Once we do the final ceremony, parents, your students will be going back through these two aisles, so we need to keep the aisles clear so they can receive their actual diploma.
Would you all please join me in giving the class of 2022 a big round of applause? Would our seniors please rise? In keeping with tradition, we would like the class of 2022 to transfer their tassels from the right to the left side of the motorboard. As of this second day of June in 2022, you are the 2022 graduates of John R. Buchtel CLC. Congratulations.
So students and adults, this concludes the graduation ceremony of the class of 2022. Yeah. Okay, the band is going to play Pomp and Ceremony on your way out. And remember to get your diplomas in the back. Find your name in the back before you go meet your parents.